What's up, YouTube, and thanks once again for tuning into our show, Morgellons Disease Discussion and Microscopy Videos. I'm your host, Jeremy Murphy, and today I wanted to do an update video on antibiotics, and in particular, expectations for taking them. A lot of people are talking online about the antibiotic effects on the Lyme bacteria, but as you can see, even going through antibiotic therapy, you're still going to experience some of the symptoms and conditions associated with the Lyme bacteria. Why is this happening? Why do antibiotics not seem to eradicate the infection? There are several reasons behind this. The number one reason, I think, is biofilm formation. This is very literally a structure that the bacteria creates inside your body to live inside, and this gives them a place to evade antibiotic intervention. A lot of people talk about biofilm busters and agents that eradicate biofilms. The problem with that is that when you're taking these agents and they do break open the pockets of bacteria that are inside the body, people often negate taking an agent which would eradicate the microbials habitating inside the biofilm structures. If they aren't addressed when they come out, when that biofilm is bust open and they flood into the bloodstream, potentially they could just habitate inside another area of the body. And that is why antibiotic intervention is appropriate. So while simultaneously taking biofilm agents, a doctor will likely put someone on antibiotics to kill whatever is coming out of them, as well as antifungal agents, immune boosting supplements. I think that's where you can really measure your expectations on how antibiotic treatment is going to affect your health. There are potential side effects from long-term antibiotic treatment, including mitochondrial dysfunction. These conditions may or may not be reversible, but what is for certain is that if these pathogenic bacteria are allowed to thrive within the body, if their homes are torn open with these biofilm busting agents, and then they go colonize elsewhere in the body, potentially, that could be a fatal incident. So to address these concerns, along with antibiotic therapy, a physician will also recommend probiotics, prebiotics, immune-boosting supplements, a change of diet, an increase in exercise, a real whole-body approach to addressing the infections. The best analogy I've heard, in a swimming pool, at the very bottom, there's a spot, a clump of this nasty-looking algae. And the swimming pool guy comes in and he shocks the pool, he puts the bleach in, bang, the water sparkling fresh, minty smelling clean, but that little green funk is still in the bottom of the pool. Bang, again, shocks the pool, next week, same results. The water smells great, looks clear, there's a patch of green funk at the bottom of the pool. So finally, what he has to do is he has to get out the scrub brush and he scrubs that green spot out, and lo and behold, it just comes up and then disintegrates inside the bleach. That's basically biofilm. That is biofilm. That green spot at the bottom of his pool was biofilm. A colony of bacteria and other microorganisms that were huddled together in this hostile environment, and they built a structure around themselves and were able to survive. You cannot cut your body open and scrub the veins out with a toothbrush. You cannot remove your organs and chuck them in the washing machine and then put them back in later and go about your day. These infections are very hard to remove, and it takes a long time for them to get built up inside the body. But as you can imagine, since it takes some years and years and decades to build up, it's going to take some years for them to be eroded, and in a safe manner. And I'm sure you could also imagine that a person would need to be monitored while going through this process. And that's part of the process, and it's going to take a little bit more time. So what should you expect if you're taking antibiotics for Morgellons? You should expect that you're going to be taking probably a combination of antibiotics, since that research has demonstrated that those are more effective than a single antibiotic in addressing antibiotic-resistant infection. You should expect that you're going to be taking probiotics, prebiotics, immune-boosting supplements, and you probably have to change your diet and exercise routines. You should expect that this is going to be a process that could take months or even years to reverse, since it took years and even decades to occur. In time, as more research occurs, we should get better drugs to address the condition than just decades-old antibiotics, as effective as they may be in combinations. If you like this video, hit that like button down below. Show your support by subscribing. Please visit our Patreon page and help us. We're writing a book called Real Morgellons, and we want it to be good and we want it to be popular. Share this video out on social media with your friends. Spread the word that Morgellons is a real condition and it is treatable in an appropriate and responsible manner.